Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Automotive, here today with a video answering the question, can you drive with a broken timing chain or belt? Cutting right to the chase in this video, no, you cannot drive with a broken timing belt or timing chain. In almost any case, if the timing belt or chain fails, it will oftentimes be catastrophic and ultimately result in the engine stalling and shutting off immediately. The timing belt is a critical engine component, and as the name suggests, it controls the timing of the engine. So if that belt suddenly snaps or jumps enough, then that is going to throw the engine completely out of balance and cause the engine to simply shut down. The slightly longer answer to this question of can you drive with a broken timing chain or belt is yes, it might be possible for the engine to continue running, and this would happen with a less severe failure in which maybe the belt or timing chain simply becomes a little loose and is allowed to jump a couple teeth or a couple ribs on the belt, in which case that will throw timing off, but it might not be off quite enough to cause any kind of catastrophic stall out or engine shutting down. However, in this case, you'll likely immediately notice very, very severe symptoms and notice the engine may continue running, but it's going to be very rough, be significantly down on horsepower, acceleration, torque, etc. Even if this happens, again, you're likely going to notice extreme symptoms right off the bat. And if the engine continues running, you might be able to drive for a short period of time, just enough to find a safe location, maybe half a mile down the road where you can pull over safely and get off of a major highway or major street, whatever the case may be. So that is a possibility. But again, a lot of the times when these timing chain or belt failures occur, timing will be thrown off enough to the point that the engine will immediately shut down. That leads me into the next brief topic, talking about the risks of timing chain or timing belt failure. Almost every modern engine is an interference engine, which means there is some overlap in the area in which the valves and pistons travel. And so if engine timing is thrown off, that can actually allow the pistons and the valves to contact each other, resulting in potentially complete engine failure. And in the very best cases, you're probably still going to be left with at least a few thousand dollars in repair bills. If those pistons and valves collide, there's a good chance some significant damage is going to happen, whether that be to the pistons themselves or at least bending a couple valves, all very complex areas of the engine to access. And even if the parts aren't too expensive, it's going to be a very labor intensive job. So ultimately, that's really the risk of timing chain or timing belt failure, is that if those pistons and valves collide, it can be very expensive, if not result in complete engine failure. And that's why it's so important to stay on top of any timing chain or timing belt services. And this is especially true in the case of timing belts. Timing chains are often meant to be more lifelong components on a vehicle. Things can still go wrong, especially with components like the timing chain tensioners, but a chain itself is usually pretty durable, except for some cases where they may stretch. But focusing on the timing belts, these are standard maintenance items, and most manufacturers and service manuals will call for replacing the timing belt roughly every 5 to 8 years, or about 50 to 100,000 miles, depending on the make and model of your vehicle. So check the service manual, understand the service intervals on those, because it is incredibly important to stay on top of it. Again, with so many engines nowadays being interference engines, a timing belt failure can be very expensive and severe. So something to stay on top of, again, understand your engine and vehicle, check that service manual. If you do have a timing belt, don't wait until the last minute to replace it. A lot of the times those service intervals do have some margin for error built in. If the manufacturer thinks that the belt should last 10 years and 120,000 miles, that's not what they're going to state for the service interval. It's going to be much shorter to leave that safety net in there, but you still don't want to push past the manufacturer's recommendation. So always stick to that and understand your vehicle and engine. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.